My name's Slavé Petrovski. I'm the Vice President and Head of AstraZeneca's Center for Genomics Research. My background training is in human and statistical genetics, and I joined AstraZeneca a couple of years ago to drive this group of genome analysts and informaticians who are responsible for building the capabilities required to analyze large-scale human genetics data. It's a 10-year initiative with the goal of analyzing the sequence data of up to 2 million human individuals. Now we're averaging around 1,300 exomes per hour for end-to-end informatics processing. Big challenge there was building up those capabilities from the ground up to ensure that we will be able to scale at 2 million genomes, which we're, you know, we're talking petabytes of genomics data, in addition to actually the informatics part of turning that raw data into information. There's also the other arm of it, which is turning that information into knowledge. And this is where the analytics team comes in. To put into context, 10 petabytes of genomics data is approximately equivalent to over 3 billion iTunes songs. When we set up with the genomics initiative, we knew that our goal being 2 million genomes would require petabytes of storage and informatics processing space. It was clear based on current provisions locally, the storage capabilities and the kind of the horsepower, if you like, was insufficient to be able to cover this. So we made the decision to go straight directly to the cloud, where we have an opportunity to have a highly scalable infrastructure, which is also very elastic in the sense it allows us to use and turn on and off as needed throughout the life cycle of the project. A big shift that's happening now that we're noticing is a migration from generating exome to whole genome data. Now, to put this into context, an exome is about 2% of our genome. An exome is 30 million data points, whereas a whole genome now, we're going to 3 billion data points per individual. At AstraZeneca, science is an important part of how we run R&D. And a key part of that is asking the killer questions at every step of the pipeline. We've embedded genomics into our drug development pipeline to help us enrich for targets that are more likely to succeed on the basis of having human genetics evidence. And so as a company, how we are using genetics can be summarized into four pillars, if you like. First one being identifying novel targets, particularly novel targets in patient populations with unmet clinical needs. Another one is actually validating or invalidating existing targets that may have come through other sources on the basis of human genetics support. So can we determine whether a particular medicine is likely or not to succeed later on if we have human genetics data earlier on? Thirdly, it's about identifying what are the market opportunities and repositioning opportunities. So we can now use genetics to identify whether inhibition of a particular target is likely to be beneficial on the basis of identifying individuals in the population who are born with natural inhibition of that target through a genetic mutation. If those individuals share the phenotypes as expected, then that is encouraging. If they don't, it starts to raise additional questions so we can do some additional research. And finally, it's about really ensuring that we match our medicines to the patients that are most likely to benefit them based on their genetic profile, their molecular cause of disease. We have a great relationship collaborating with Illumina, particularly the engineering team, on the various Dragon pipelines that they're working on. The one that we focus on primarily at the moment is the Dragon germline pipeline. I'm proud to work for a company that pushes the boundaries of science to identify new opportunities for medicines for patients with unmet clinical needs. And we can use genomics to help us achieve this by identifying individuals in the population who are most likely to benefit from particular medicines.